Hello everybody and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Genshin Impact. It's the 9th of September right now. It's been almost a week since I last did a video of this. And you can see that I don't have many days left on Welkin Moon. Obviously by the time this comes out, most people will probably already know what had been going on. But just to give, and you might notice that I'm in a slightly different place than I stopped at the last episode. That's because a few days ago I actually tried to do an episode of this, but I got in for about 20 seconds and then I left, so it didn't really turn into anything. But just to kind of give a little bit of an explanation here of what happened and what's going to be happening. My mouth pain that I've been talking about for a little while and, you know, throughout the past episodes and in some other LPs like Baldur's Gate 3 and stuff. It came full swing. Painkillers weren't working. It was very, very bad. And on the 5th, I went to the dentist. And I already did a video, a channel update detailing all this, but I went to the dentist, got all of the information I needed on going to have surgery done to get teeth removed and all that crap, but that's not happening until the 10th of October. And I've just been kind of just existing since then. The experience was not expected, even though I've had mouth pain in the past. For some reason, this was, I think, worse than it's ever been. So I've just kind of been idling a lot, existing, sleeping when I can. And the pain has thankfully gone down. I've been taking antibiotics and all that kind of stuff. But my biggest worry is that once my antibiotics are out, which will be in about 2 days, that my pain's gonna come back, and I still have a full month before my consultation, and that's not even the actual surgery, that's just consultation. So yeah, needless to say, I'm not exactly very happy right now, mentally, because this is not very different. This isn't the same type of, like, depression of, like, oh, I'm lonely, you know, or sad because of my future goals or something. It's not like that. This is akin to what I experienced back in 2017 when I got sick and then, you know, had the acute pericarditis and all that kind of stuff, which, like, came out of left field. It all happened in the blink of an eye, and it was very shocking for me, so it kind of freaked me out. And for some reason, that's what's happening to me now. So I don't have, like, an appetite. I don't have a thirst. I don't have a desire to really do much. And I have this constant dread, this worry that, you know, stuff is going to get worse or go wrong, even though technically, finally, I am actually going to hopefully be getting my teeth worked on this time. You know, I'm going to get the teeth removed that need to be taken out. I'm going to improve the teeth that still exist, et cetera, et cetera. It's just that it's so far away and I'm just, you know what I mean? I don't know. It's a little bit too much to explain right now. This is the first time I have sat down to record a video in a week, like, period, aside from the channel update video. Like, I haven't recorded anything else. I put my Baldur's Gate LP on hold. I put everything else on hold. I haven't been logging into Genshin dailies. In fact, the pain was so bad a couple nights that I forgot entirely to even log in to get the Welkin Moon. It was just that hard to focus on anything. So I did miss some of my Welkin Moon logins, unfortunately, as a result. But we're here now, and I'm not sure how long I'll be playing because I'm going to try to eat an actual meal for the first time in 7 days, 9 days, in a little bit here. But needless to say, though, it's been a bit rough, and hopefully things will improve. Everyone keeps telling me it will improve. My dentist says that, my parents say that, Aki and some of my friends say that. So, you know, I just have to trust that that's how it's going to be. And of course, Genshin, as it has always done, is going to capture all of that in the LP before the surgery, after the surgery, well, maybe not immediately after the surgery, but, you know, after I've recovered from it, it's all going to be captured here in Genshin, hopefully. But anyways, we'll see how my pain is handled here. Right now, I think I'm dealing with, like, phantom pain, if that makes any sense. Not because I'm missing limbs or anything, but because I have the pain in that side of the mouth was so extreme and got so bad, and then it took a couple days to subdue itself after I started taking the antibiotics, that I still feel something. but it's not pain. Like, it doesn't hurt, if that makes sense, but I feel something on that side of the mouth. Like, this dull pressure, you know? Not a dull ache, it's just this pressure. And I just assume that it's in effect of my mouth, that side of the mouth is in so much pain that now that it's not in pain, the body, the gums are still feeling that effect. I don't know how to really explain it, but whatever. Anyways, so that's kind of where we're at right now and where we're going moving forward, hopefully. But yeah, October 10th, and it's only September 9th, and there's like 30 or 31 days in September, so it's technically still over a month away. And let's just say that hearing the news that I would be getting my mouth worked on was so relieving, and then getting the news that it wouldn't be for over a month, yeah, that was pretty crushing. Especially because I got that news while I was curled up in a ball in pain. So, yay for that, I guess. Anyways, we'll do our best here to try to play some stuff. I didn't really get to do any of my weeklies this week. It's Saturday night. It's going to be Sunday in like 2 hours. So, like in an hour and a half, it'll actually be Sunday. Though the weekly will flip over in like 6 hours from now. But yeah, I haven't played it all this week, so like we can open this up and you can see I'm level 38. I think I did get my login bonus when I tried to play before, so if the XP bar isn't exactly where it was in the last proper episode, because I just deleted that opening, that like 20 seconds I recorded. I tried recording it on the 5th of September, which was the day I went into the dentist, which was also, I think, the highest my peak had been for pain was on that day. And the pain didn't start subsiding until the 6th, and then it rose back up really bad, and then on the 7th, the pain died down further, and then on the 8th, which was yesterday, the pain was, I'd say, mostly gone. And I still have, like I said, 2 days of antibiotics left right here, and that's the only thing I can hope is that the antibiotics are going to at least temporarily destroy whatever the fuck was going on in my mouth for long enough until I get my mouth work done, because if that pain comes back, I think I'm fucked. But regardless, so I looked at some of the stuff in here, like I looked at the new banner, for example. So like if I go to, you'll see that the wish thing isn't, it isn't giving me a notification, and that's because I think I selected, I selected the polearm, although I selected that in pain, so I didn't really think about it, not that it matters. But yeah, I missed the Yellen banner. Well, I say I missed it. Of course I missed it because I wasn't playing, because I was dealing with my mouth, but that's fine. I wasn't like it wasn't too important for me to try to get Yellen. I was just thinking maybe I would do it just because that way we could have an extra fun poll episode. But now you can see that we got the new banners. We've got Zhongli and Tartaglia here, and the 4 stars that are available are Noel, Sayu, and this new 4-star character, Fermente, or whatever the hell his name is. I don't remember what his name is exactly. But, yep, so I probably will not be pulling on either of these banners. I know there is a new 4-star character, and it does suck to have to miss one of those, but I'm very close to my 5-star. Well, somewhat close to my 5-star. I'm like 40 or 50 into pity. And I don't want to accidentally get a constellation for, you know, one of these two characters, which I already have, just to try to get a new 4-star that also is a Claymore user. So that's where I'm standing on that right now. So we'll be completely, like, there isn't even any thought. Like, there's no, maybe I'll pull on the banner. There's none of that. I'm not pulling on this banner at all. This is entirely going to be skipped for me. Which I believe that the banner I will probably be pulling on is the next set of banners. And in that case, that's when I'll actually finally be able to start putting all of these resources that we've been gathering, which, as you can see, we've got a straight 24.9 thousand of these Prima Gems saved up. So, yeah. Now, I don't know what's new for stuff here. Okay, it looks like we've got one of these things, a fighting event, might be good for some extra Prima Gems. We're done with that. Test run, we can do those, of course, for some extra Prima Gems, and I don't think there's really anything else important going on right now. Okay, and let me see what else we've got here. Okay, mail. These are probably my daily check-ins. Yeah, see, I have been trying to get my check-ins each day as best I can, but I might have missed... I think I did miss one, but I was able to use the you know, makeup one day. So we got some food, we got some EXP, some money, some more EXP. No primogems. I think tomorrow's check-in reward is primogems. And this is for that event ending. Check-in reward, some more money. An event survey. So it looks like I got a survey for more money. And we've got two things here. Exercise Evil from Chong Yun. Deeply aware of your fame and leeway for your heroic deeds, and I presume you wouldn't miss such an opportunity? Why not join me and indulge in the thrill of battle for a day? Okay, cold noodles with mountain delicacies. We get one of his foods, and we get... Oh, that's pretty nice. 10 mist flower things. And then we got one from Razor here. Smell your scent. Okay, and we got an event survey. I guess we'll go ahead and do this, because we have actually done the events, so... This shouldn't be too problematic. I was going to try to do, because I think Aki is installing the game, reinstalling or updating Genshin, and I would like to try to play some Genshin with her tonight if I can. I might, you know, if I don't sound very enthusiastic, it's just, right now it's not because of the pain, it's just because of my diminished mood after that and the worry about it getting worse again, you know, so it is what it is. Okay, when were you born? We know this shit. I was born 1998. I am of the male variety. Yes, I have done that. I have heard of this event. I have participated in the Mega Mecha Melee event. How satisfied are you? I'd say I'm trying to remember. I'd say it's somewhat satisfied. What are the reasons for your satisfaction? I do like the content of the Fontaine area. The event gameplay was interesting, and the time required to obtain rewards was just right. How is your exploration progress? Wait a minute, this has nothing to do with the event. I've explored most of the new regions. How satisfied are you with version 4.0's new region, the Court of Fontaine? Oh, okay. I'm very satisfied. How satisfied are you with the mechanisms and puzzles in the new regions of version 4.0? Mechanisms and puzzles include the energy blocks, hydrogranum, seagrass. I'd say I'm neutral, because they're not really puzzles. You know what I mean? They're all grab this thing, touch this other thing, or break this other thing. There's no real, like, block puzzles or anything like that. What are the main reasons for your dissatisfaction with the mechanisms and puzzles? Lack of guidance? No. The rewards? No. The gameplay is too repetitive? No. I can't tell if the gameplay related has been unlocked or not? No. The gameplay is not fun. Underwater control? No. Still too difficult? No. Some mech? No. Time required? No. What? No. I guess I'll go for other. That's my stance on it. How satisfied with P-related gameplay? I just say I'm neutral. I don't really care too much. How satisfied with the new abilities? Xenochromatic Armored Crab. Okay, and then we got the Blubber Beast. The Armored Crab ability, I'd say I'm somewhat satisfied. Blubber Beast, I'm neutral. And the Hunter's Ray, I'm very satisfied with how that one feels. Have you encountered any issues or poor experiences when using the mechanics related to creature abilities? I haven't. Don't know how to absorb. No, there are too few game modes and can't find the desired creatures. That's not a problem. I can't aim accurately. That's not a problem. The gameplay related to abilities is too repetitive. I don't know, could be, but it's not really a problem for me. The process of finding and changing abilities is cumbersome. Finding and changing ability. No, not really. I haven't had that issue yet. There are too few abilities to use. There are too few, but I don't really consider that a problem. The target hit by the attack was not the one I intended to hit. I haven't had that problem, I don't think, too much. The gameplay related to abilities is boring. I don't know, it could be, but again, it's not a problem for me. I didn't know I could hold the ability button. I didn't encounter any issues. How satisfied with the following mechanisms and puzzles? The echoing conch. I don't know, I'd say I'm neutral on that. It just, you know, kind of just works. The relay, I'm neutral on. The seagrass, I'd say I'm somewhat satisfied because at least it's fun to aim. Hydrogranna and water volume detection crystals. These things? I forgot about these. These are like the only proper puzzle that I remember because it's down to timing and stuff. So I'd say I'm somewhat satisfied with those. How satisfied with the following mechanisms and puzzles? Beastly Rift. I've seen this thing on one of the islands, but I don't think I interacted with it, so I'm going to say I haven't tried it. How would you rate the difficulty of the following mechanisms and puzzles? The seagrass is very easy. The relay, very easy. The hydrogranna stuff, I'd say somewhat easy. It depends. Echoing conch, very easy. This is what I'm talking about. Like, all of the puzzles. I'm not asking for, you know, fucking rocket science here, but as much as I really enjoy Fontaine, I do think that some of the puzzles are just a bit too simple compared to, like, Inazuma, where, you know, some of those block puzzles were a little bit challenging and fun, or those tile ones on the ground where you had to light up the certain patterns and stuff. That those were fun, too. Why am I getting messages now? Oh, shit. Okay, next. How satisfied are you with the underwater combat experience? I am neutral, I would say. I'd say the underwater combat experience is... Oh, here we go. How interesting do you find them in combat? Somewhat boring. That's why I'm kind of neutral on it. Everything underwater, the exploration, the swimming, everything's smooth and enjoyable. And using the powers is fun. It's just that I think the act of combat is a bit too samey with everything compared to the combat you'd have, you know, on the ground. How difficult did you find it to survive underwater? I'd say it's just right. I don't have any issues. Well, actually, I'd say it's actually somewhat easy. How do you find that? That's not an issue either, though. How do you find the frequency of fights underwater? Frequency? Low. How satisfied are you with the difficulty of surviving underwater? I am somewhat satisfied. I'm happy that I don't keep getting knocked out. Before heading to Fontaine, did you know that the new teleport waypoint has been added to the map? I know. I just didn't know it was going to be a thing. You have any other comments regarding to share about version 4.0 regarding its new regions or other content? If so, please leave a... Fontaine has been absolutely stunning. Love almost every bit about it. Okay. Survey complete. Now let me see if I can do any of my weeklies and stuff. Why is it still telling me that there's... Oh, this. Oh, and it's Fontaine themed, huh? I guess. What the fuck is this thing? Dewdrop. 70 primogems for each stage. Well, we might look at that at some point, too. I don't know. Right. We got these test runs. Let's get these out of the way now. Kind of remember some of these characters. Again, I'm probably not going to spend too long reading about them because I'm just here for the rewards right now. It's not like I'm trying to decide on if I want the character or not. I don't know what I'm doing. She does like a thing or something here.
2 months, man.
Get out of here, you little shit. Alright, success. Challenge completed. Now that I have successfully beaten the game, I can move on to, of course, Noelle's not going to get a playtest. Okay, we got this new 4-star here. Ferminate, I don't know. Trial. Gives me some stuff. I'll try to read his since he's a new character. Let's see. His elemental skill will generate Purr's timer. Purr timer. Current pressure level. It will infuse his normal attacks with cryo. When unleashing his elemental skill once again, while it's active, he will perform different sorts of attacks based on the pressure level of his timer. And his elemental burst can reset the cooldown of his skill. While his elemental burst is active, the cooldown of his elemental skill will be decreased. Okay, well, here he is. Stands like a Genshin character, he runs like a Genshin character, he stops like a Genshin character. He's got... Oh god, I can already tell his attack speed is really slow. That is my biggest issue with these types of... He's got the classic Claymore swing, or spin, I mean. And then we got Micah over here, I don't even fucking remember this guy. They both have something on their back. Oh, fuck it, whatever. Oh, I see, there's the timer. I guess if I do it again... It does something? I don't know. Jesus. Dude, it's difficult, man. Oh my god, he puts a diving helmet on? Okay, that's kind of cool, though. The detail of the diving helmet is pretty interesting. I mean, it feels fun to play, but... Couldn't tell you what the fuck is going on. Oh my god, did he? Wait. Has that always been an effect? Dude, how long have people broken into chunks of ice when you kill them? I don't think I ever remember seeing that. That's kind of brutal. Look, the dude's legs are down here and the rest of him is ice chunks. That's not child friendly. Okay, and now for the two big chunguses. Got child over here. I don't remember. I think he's got like that thing where he can switch between a bow and swords or something like that. And he's got a bow normally. And then I can press E to switch to water melee. Which is pretty cool, I guess. Let's see. I'll do some stuff here. Okay, his melee thing is on cooldown. Okay, I'm clearly marking them. But I'm probably marking them for his burst, I guess. I didn't read it. That's why you do read. Okay, I thought I pressed E, but I think I pressed it twice, so I reset it again. Whoops. Oh no, one more. That wasn't so bad. I could see him being fun to play, I suppose. In due time. He'll get his chance to shine, I'm sure. Alright, and last but not least, Zhongli, everyone's favorite. Something about a shield and something about a pillar. Damage. Okay, so he can summon a stone, steel. Holding his elemental skill creates a shield. His burst summons meteor flying from the sky, dealing... Okay. So, this is him. Alright, he's got that cool thing where he, like, uses the force with his pole arm. That is pretty cool. Oh, shit, that's cool, too. Damn. Okay, so, holding will give me... Well, okay, let's just try pressing it once. Alright, there it is. There's just the pressing. Oops. Oh, who the hell is this? And then, like, holding it gives a shield, I guess. Yeah, that is a meteor. That'll do it. Oh god, you can climb the pillar? Oh, you could use that in world exploration. I see we're gonna do this shit, aren't we? Okay, so it's turned him into stone man, I guess. There we go. Alright, I'm done. Damn it. Well, hey, the rewards are nice, just for getting to playtest a character. Yeah, I'll probably look at that. This event too at some point, unless the mouth pain gets bad. I don't know. Depends. All just depends on what happens in the future. I'm also gonna be eating in a few minutes, so that might fuck up my mouth too. We'll see. Mail. Okay. What is the other stuff? Okay. So at this point, what I want to do is weeklies, and I don't really have to worry about not hitting 50. Because if I buy the battle pass, all I have to do is get 2 levels. I need to get to level 40, and then the battle pass would jump me up. If I bought the 20, that is. I guess I don't have to do that. The normal one is only 10. But this one doesn't give me the plus 10 stuff. But either way, assuming I do that... Stomach is killing me with the flight. It's probably because I haven't eaten in like 7 days. But let's see, complete 4 daily commissions, mine items. Yeah, so you're doing our dailies. This will hit us up to level 39 at least. And the weeklies, then I'm not gonna be able to get them all done, but like I said, I only need to hit level 40 really. That's my only goal. So in fact, it looks like I could pretty much hit it right now if I do the Trounce domains. Well, let's get our dailies out of the way then, quick. Because that'll be the quickest and easiest thing to do. And they're in Sumeru, it looks like. Operation. I can smell the food. It smells good. That's a good thing, at least. I haven't had that appetite at all in so long. And it feels good to actually, you know, be like, food. And I've never had this type of food before, so it shall be a new experience. Alright, where are you taking me? Alright, we did this one not too long ago, actually. Wrong way. Alright, next. What have we got over here? Swift Slayer. Time trial challenge. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Okay, so next daily, we're almost done with these. Oh shit, we got one of these city ones. Where the fuck is the other one? Down here. Fungi Buster. Alright, down we go. This is just combat, right? Yeah, with these guys. It's fine. Hello! How did you live?
Yep.
Shit,
I switched to the wrong character. I'm like, really out of it at the moment. We got it, though. Prima gems. Oh, there's some special magic crystals and stuff over there. What the frick? Oh man, look at that, all tightly packed together. Crystal, magic, iron, and white iron. That's like perfect kit right there. Crystal and magic. Crystal, iron, and white iron. I'm gonna go ahead and grab it too while we're here. Last daily, we can get these out of the way. Because if I play with Aki tonight, I won't be able to, even if I do my dailies through her world, I won't be able to turn them in without leaving. Go to the place marked and get some soil. Stupid music. Fishing location over there.
Gacha!
Oops. Whatever. Oh, let me go turn this in quick. Thankfully, Catherine's right here. Catherine's right here. Benito. Kichingo. Shinheo. Shanglingo. Level 39, very nice. Okay, now just our resin usage, which I think I can do that easily by actually could just cook and forge some dishes. I mean, it doesn't really matter. I'm still gonna do like my reputation and stuff, hopefully. In fact, you know what, let's go do that right now. I don't know if I'll do it, be able to do it before I eat, though. I don't think I have enough time for that, because the food's supposed to be done very shortly. I can at least grab it, and I will do my reputation in Sumeru again. Alright, requests. Let's see. Eremites. Eremites, okay. And Ruin Drake, so they're all combat requests. And today's bounty is going to be invulnerable to electro damage. Okay, looks like we'll have to bring Ganyu out then. Takes increased damage from claymores. Let's go fight a whole bunch of Eremites. That's where the big guy is. Group of Eremites, and then some Ruin Drake stuff, I guess. Oh, this is the one that's like right next to a normal one, right? Well, this is Drake or Drakes, so maybe it is supposed to be two of them. To get rid of Fischl for just a moment, bring Ganyu in for just a moment, And we're going to go fight Mr. Invulnerable to Electro over here. Which probably means that Nahida's not going to be too useful, but it's fine. I'll throw Okay, I have consumed my food, and I am going to, let's see, invulnerable to hydro, Nemo resistance, that's fine. Over in the mushroom place, yeah. I'm going to do my best here to finish up my weekly stuff, or some of the weekly stuff I've got. Oh, that's why this is so weird. Oh, what the fuck? I managed that, but somehow I did. Alright, anyways. Easy peasy. Lemon ass. Now back into Sumeru City for one more. One more go around. And this should give me exactly enough for level 8 in reputation. Immune to pyro damage. Dendro cores will be increased. Takes damage dealt by dendro cores. Dendro resistance is decreased. Okay. And this time I have the waypoint next to it. So I can get there relatively easily. Alright, that's our our reputation done for the week. For Sumeru, whatever. Bam. Nice, level 8 reputation. Which gives us a Dendroculus Resonant Stone. Yay, we won't be needing that for a long time anyways. So we've got a long ways to go yet for the wings, but we're getting there. Slowly but surely. Okay, and bam and bam, and there you go, level 40 on the BP. This is another fate for us. So I might end up, excuse me, I might pick up the battle pass, because that is still something I would like to do. I'll have to do some thinking, though, some financing first to see if that's appropriate at the moment, and I think it is. Let's see, I don't think Aki's logged on yet, has she? She didn't send me a message. No, last online, still ages ago. Okay, well, what do I do now? We're up to 47 minutes. Well, I guess I can do, like, I can use my resin, I suppose. Unless I was to keep it to help with Aki. Well, I don't know. My resin's not gonna help with Aki. Let's do some of the weekly boss fights, then. Why is my throat, like, dying? Hello? What the fuck? Oh, that's right. I'll do the wolf next. I have to remember that I blew all of his materials. Ow. I don't like that purple thing that's on me now. Oh, okay. No. I didn't lose anybody there. Alright. There's our stuff for this run. Next. Big wolfy time, methinks. Big wolf, big wolf. Big woof. Crystal flies. I was distracted when I spawned in there. My abilities ready to go here. MiHoYo. Hop. One. Alright, you bastard. Hit me with your best shot, asshole. Damn, I actually hit him there. That was interesting. He doesn't have the green anymore. Alright, now give him a chance to go through his transformation phase here. Mr. Wolf is dead. Mr. Wolf will give me some stuff. Thank you, Mr. Wolf. Okay, now let's go and let's fight the Storm Terror. And how would this leave us on? 30? This leave me on 70. So I'll have 10 resin left over, I guess, if I do one more weekly. Okay. This isn't gonna really mean much, but level 41, yay. And as for the resin I've got left, 70. Did I make condensed resin in the past? I don't remember if I had actually done that. Doesn't look like I have any condensed resin on me. Oh, I do. 4. Well, I could turn my other one into... Yeah, you know what? I'm going to do that. Actually, I should... No, people are going to tell me, you should prioritize the weekly bosses because they're about to reset, so... God damn it. Which I guess is, you know, mostly true here. Oh, what do we want to reset then? Or if I did spend one, I guess Nahida or that other boss that I don't have any characters that it's important for. I suppose we can do Nahida's boss then. Fine, fuck it, I'll just do this. Frick, dude. Food was pretty good, but I just have to wait and see how my body reacts to it. So I've had the fucking shits recently, and I think that's just because I haven't been eating anything.
ご助力を。渦潮よ。瑠璃のように落ちなさい。はい。はぎ取りなさい。陣営のごとく。
Oh, this is a really bad place to... Ow. Alright, my way through it, fuck this other mechanic. Oh, you... Oh, hold on, I'm ready. Ow. Some stuff. Some magic stuff. What? Oh, that's for that fighting event. Actually, you know what? Let me check with Aki and see how far she is on her download, and then maybe... I could go check out that event thing, just to, you know, slip it in. I don't know, we're already up to an hour though. I don't really have that much storage space. Well, how long does that event even have? Eight days. It doesn't hurt to check it out quick to see what it entails. I see a hilichurl thing over there. Oh yeah, that is explorable area. Can just barely make out a desert hilichurl camp. Well, this seems like a fighting arena, so... When a character loses HP, oh, there's a steadfast thing. Looks like you do get a reward for completing it on steadfast mode, and perilous difficulty is what you get for the main thing. Desperate. Complete the challenge within 180 seconds is all the ones. Well, let's just see what Desperate does. This might actually be completable in like 10, 15 minutes. Great, we got this shit here. They want me to use the mechanics here. I'm curious to see how we can handle it on our own, actually. Nope. Not doing this. We're doing this, aren't we? Oh, now it feels like a domain I'm grinding for artifacts. Well, we did it. Okay, exit. All it took was some brute force. I don't think it's... I'm not going to do steadfast mode just to get four extra little chinguses. I'm just going to get the main rewards here. When a character triggers quicken, aggravate, spread burning and bloom reactions against their opponents, or deal to opponents damage to opponents through dendro cores, the opponent's defense will be decreased. Oh, I just have to do it here. Okay. Okay, these are gonna be the big guys. Okay, challenge completed. And engulfing torrents. Electrocharged and vaporized reactions do stuff. I'm still gonna just see if I can manage. There's bonuses for crit for applying frozen too, apparently, but. Oh, these aren't the. This isn't what I was expecting to fight. Yeah, those things in the middle, that's what I was expecting to fight. This is where all of my spam clicking is going to be going into here. Okay, we did it. Just barely. Alright. So yeah, this is very quick to complete. Now we're fighting Fatui stuff and treasure hoarders. Elemental charge and burst damage is increased. Okay. That doesn't sound too bad.
Okay,
What? How did that... What the fuck? How the fuck did that not hit the other guy? I don't know how this guy didn't get greedy. Oh, he still did it. That one was quicker than the other ones. Give me those human enemies. Alright, change the wrath. Now it's Hilichurls. Attack speed is increased. Plunging attack damage is increased. Fuck that shit. Just give me what I want here. Was even easier, damn. Okay, and charge and breach. We're fighting the mecha stuff. Healing bonus. Alright. Oops, I didn't need the green again, that was a mistake. It looks like there's gonna be one big enemy here. Oh, you are a little shit, aren't you? Looks like you need two of these? Yeah, I guess because he is a big enemy. Okay, and that is all of the event reward, the primary rewards, that is. Hell yeah, that was some easy primigems right there. And it looks like it's just four extra things for the steadfast mode. What even is steadfast? It's probably just like, get it done even quicker or something. It looks like it's different enemies, so it's probably harder. Okay, and I completed a BP period thing now. Level 43. Well, in that case then, let's find somewhere. Where do we want to go? Let's go to Fontaine. Notices, I don't know if there's anything important in there. Okay, and I will be with you in just a moment. Okay, so before I stop this video here, I'm gonna try, it's actually now past midnight, so it's technically the 10th of September now. 1 month from now is my consultation for surgery on my mouth, or so I would hope. Anyways, what I'm gonna do now quick is I'm gonna take a look at the battle pass, because I might not actually buy the $20 one, mainly because I'm not really too into this name card and this build. I mean, that would be cool, yeah, but it's not so much when you can hardly put anything in your fucking house anyways, you know, so trying to put multiple large buildings would be pretty shitty. And the 5 resin would be really nice, but if I can get some extra weekly stuff in here, I mean, the next weeklies are going to start in, you know, 2 hours from now. That's not the next weeklies. I forgot. That'll be Sunday. The next weeklies are in 24 hours after that. Shit. Okay, I'm off by a little bit. But the next dailies will start in 2 hours. If I can get up to level 50 in the next day, then I shouldn't have any problem just getting the $10 one, which will still give me the 4-star special weapon. I just don't get these extra 3 bonuses or the free 10 levels. I say free, you used to have to buy it, but... So, yeah, I think that's probably what I'll do to save myself a little bit of money, since we're so close to reaching level 50 anyways. There's 15 days left on this. Make a total of 50 wishes. No. Okay, so use a total of 1,200 resin. So we'll do some things now, like we can do these cooked dishes and forge things. And maybe go and look for this stuff. We can get a few of these out of the way, the realm currency, etc. Get a couple levels. But we probably won't be able to get all the way to level 50 until I reach the next set of weeklies. So, okay, let's go do some cooking. Do that over where we always do, our traditional location, here in Mondstadt. Shouldn't be too hard at all. Aki is about fucking an hour ago. Hell, it wasn't even an hour ago. It was 2 hours ago? No, it was an hour ago. Okay, it was not 2 hours ago. An hour ago. Aki's thing is still downloading. It dropped in download speed, so... We probably won't be doing that until a little bit later this morning. Like to have something made, please. Can I have this made? Thank you. Okay. Should have made it with white iron, but I fucked it up. And now we get to do the fun part, cooking more foods. I always enjoy doing this, so... Cook. And I gotta go through these and see. I know we got some new foods, I think. Nothing new there. I still wish it would tell me. Ah, here we go. So we can do 5 of these. Perfect. 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 And perfect. And we got a poo one. Okay. So next, let's see, that's 5 that we've got done. We got a weird number there, a weird number here. Oh, I guess we're gonna make some mushroom pizza then. That'd be 9 that we can make. Okay, and it looks like Gene has a special dish. We might need to craft up some more cheese. Oh, we got the special dish too, very nice. Or no, that's just the double. I don't think that's her special dish. It says that she can also double the product, 12% chance. There, that's her special food.
Master Gene is a bitch.
All right. Got 40 cheese left. And cheese takes milk, right? Yeah. let's make, just make 30 more cheese. And can I buy milk from you? Yes, I will buy all of your milk. Thank you. Okay, and let me also check and see how many, because I lost count. How many of these do I have left? Okay, we need to cook 6 more dishes. That should be easy. Where were we at? We were down here somewhere. Next to the pizza. Okay, so we need to cook 6 of these Mondstadt hash browns. Oh, these actually take pine cones. That's actually, what? Are pine cones actually used as a cooking ingredient? Like IRL? I don't think my hash browns have pine cones in them. Oil-rich seeds. Oh, okay. Maybe that's what they use them for. And it looks like I don't have a character pre-selected. Razor may make a special dish. Okay, and it's also going to take jam, which we're pretty low on, but let's see. Cook. 1. 2. Oh, his special dish will be the things we just got from his birthday, right? The little paw-shaped hash browns. Oops. Stop. Oh. Well, I accidentally made a shit version. I didn't mean to do that, but whatever. I got what I needed. I was just trying to cancel it, but whatever. We've got a poo version now. That's actually my first... Oh no, yeah, that was my first suspicious one. I already had hash browns, apparently. Okay, let's go grab... the craftables, quick. Mr. Owl. Okay. Bam and bam. Okay, now we can... Let's see. Domain challenges. I might end up actually getting that done by playing with Aki. But obtain 1,000 realm currency. Yeah, and this. I think I can do these two things pretty easily. And maybe the furnishings, too. I don't know why I've got, like, a little cough thing going on here. Okay, let me go to the pot. This is full here. Bam. Okay. Grab these. Thank you. Let me go to the Realm Depot. Oh, that's right. I can buy like this transient resin. And these. Which they're actually very expensive though. Okay. I think I really have much for like interior that I haven't already built, and I don't know how much stuff interior wise I'd want to continue building. I guess we've got a whole bunch of, where the fuck did all this stuff come from? That's new. Oh, a sword rack, that might be pretty cool. We can do this as well here. Create. Do 10, so I'll create one of those. Go ahead and create one of these. Yeah, why not? Create one of these. And one of these. Damn, what the fuck? All this extra shit. Oh, a lot of this is Fontaine stuff, isn't it? Yeah, I don't have the right trees. Oh, we can make one of these Fontainian chairs just to see. Okay, that's all of our creations in here. So let's get those out of the way quick. Yeah. Right, we got some new shit for us now. Boink, very nice, that's level 44, and boink, almost level 45. Location TCG, that would be worth quite a bit. How about we do this? Let's go look for somebody to steal from quick. I'll do what I did last time and pull from somebody that hasn't logged into the game in a while. Oh, they need that. Okay, we're getting into triples. Place of home. Where the fuck is the person to buy from? Oh, Neko. Oh, this must be... Is this the Sumeru one? Or is this... What is this place? Is this not Sumeru? Is this like Leeway or Monster? I don't actually know what this place is. I don't know if I've seen it. Looks very Leeway though, with these style of large places. Anyways, let's see, where the fuck is that asshole at? Oh, there she is. Oh, okay, I mean this, yeah. There's a fast travel point here to make it convenient. And a kitty. Nice, another Radiant Spin Crystal. I'll go ahead and yoink that. And I need to buy one more thing. I have all of these, so I'll just buy whatever's cheap here. I'll buy one of these. There we go. Bought two items. Level 45. Nice. Five levels away. So, there is other stuff I could do here, but I would need to... Well, some of it, I guess I wouldn't need the resin. Like, I could just fight bosses and not claim the materials. That's so annoying to do that. If I'm gonna fight the boss, I kinda want the materials. There is some other stuff on here I could do, but I think I'll have to wait until the new set of weeklies start over, and then I should be able to. With that mixed with the dailies that happen in 2 hours from now, should be enough to push me... What is that again? That's 300. That might be enough to get me to level 46, so... At the start of next week, I should be in a good place to finish the battle pass, and then I'll probably buy it at that point. and then claim all of the additional rewards. So yay. Get myself an extra boost, some extra pulls. Not very many. I think it's like four fates is what I'll get out of it. But I'll also get 680 Prima Gems and a new weapon for the day that I might end up actually needing that on the character. This background's very nice. Okay. Well, anyways, let's go ahead and leave. I guess I'll end that up in this episode here, because I think I did most everything that I kind of wanted to do, and hopefully we'll get to do another episode in a little bit, where I'll probably end up doing my dailies in a co-op episode. We'll see, though. It all just depends on what Aki and I get up to, what she's willing to do. I feel like shit right now. God, I have like no enthusiasm for anything. It sucks. Okay, well, anyways. Until next time, I'll see you guys in Let's Play Genshin Impact, or whatever. Or, I don't know, if that didn't make any sense.